When people come to Glastonbury, they should see hippies, ley lines and the beautiful view of a tower towering in the sunset.
The hidden gem is the Mary Magdalene Chapel. It's beautiful, it's really peaceful energy.
Glastonbury people all get on very well together. We've got witches and fairies and ghouls and just ordinary Glastonbury folk.
If Glastonbury was an animal, it would have to be a colourful parrot that does not do what's expected and does not look how it's expected to look.
If we were trying to describe it as an animal, we just couldn't, because most people here would be vegetarians.
Mark Steele's in town.
Thank you very much. Welcome to Mark Steele's in town, which this week comes from the Somerset town of Glastonbury, one of the most delightful places in the world to go shopping, as long as you're in desperate need of a tarot card. Or a bucket of hemp. If you need a pint of milk, you've got to go to Bristol. Because this is the hippiest, new ageist place in the world. If indeed it is in the world. For example, we are at the Assembly Rooms, and this is the only theatre I've ever been to where it says on the What's On brochure, incense may be lit inside the venue. I know you won't believe it, Glastonbury, but other areas, the theatres don't have that. In Glasgow, very few people go, "Shall we take the kids to the pantomime tonight? Only if we can burn the incense or I'm not going." Now, of course, I do have to establish early on here for listeners that there is a motto in this town, which is, "This is Glastonbury, which is not where they have the festival that's 7 miles away." So we will come on to the festival in a bit, but first it has to be said that if you're after a place of spiritual, floaty, crystal-healing, chanty things, then Glastonbury will not disappoint. Lots of shops sell dream catchers. Actually, I expect a really bad anxiety dream here is, I dreamt that I went up the tour at summer solstice and I wasn't naked in front of all the neighbours. It's just so embarrassing. The shops in the High Street have the most wonderful names. The Psychic Piglet, Myth and Magic. Everywhere sells crystals and Sharma healing. It's so new age. When I saw a place that did aromatherapy, I thought, well, that's the down-to-earth industrial part of the High Street. Selling something that I've heard of, the equivalent of an ironmonger's in another town. This is the only high street in the world where if you wanted to describe someone that you were looking for and said, they look like a wizard, it wouldn't help. Whatever you believe, it must be fun here. Where else could you get an incident that causes this headline in the local paper? Woman dressed as vagina stops street fight. Stops street fight between a passerby and a man dressed as a penis. Did anyone see that? Did you? Yes. Who saw it? Do you think this is normal? Like if you go to Bridgewater or Taunton, do you walk around thinking, this is a weird place, no one's dressed as genitals involved in a brawl? There's a goddess temple in the High Street. Everywhere else in Britain, the Woolworths became a Poundland. Here it became an organic vegan supermarket. There's a place called the Chocolate Love Temple. Now, in any other town, I would assume that was a shop selling posh chocolates, but here I expect it is actually the headquarters of a religion that worships the Aero. There is a market here. I saw the market on a Tuesday, but I bet even there the stallholders are going, all right, ladies and gentlemen, witches and wizards, here we go. I'll tell you what I've got for you today. I've got earth dancing, incense, seven colour chakras, tumble stones for your aura, your gaia, your adenoids, your hemorrhoids. Look at this dream catcher. It'll catch you. Can't move your legs because they're stuck in ginseng dream. You have to deliver a cranial massage workshop in the morning. I haven't prepared it in time, dream, and I'm not asking. A monkey, 2 score, £35. I'll tell you what goddess is. He's a bit on the telly, crime watch. I'm only laughing about with you, ladies and gentlemen. Gentlemen, stick your hands up. Who wants one? These are 60 quid in the Psychic Piglet. £15. One of the brilliant things about the high street here, you've got all these shops, and the one chain store that you do have, you've got two branches of, which is Boots the Chemist's. I'm kind of thinking you've made yourself so ill with all the crystal healing. You need two, because you're always popping in for a Nurofen. There is one other chain store here, which is William Hill's. I thought, God, they're taking a chance with all the clairvoyance, aren't they? I love that there's an ethical hairdresser's here, which is, I think, thank Lord for that, because I'm so sick of having to go to hairdressers that are war criminals. There's a local paper here that is glorious, called The Oracle. I'm sure you're familiar with. There's a column in the recent one that goes, "Each day I walk up the tour barefoot before sunrise. With each step I'm saying, dear Mother Earth, I love you, I honour you. I then wash at the spring, head home, meditate, chant, followed by a goji berry hemp milk, red for base chakra for breakfast." And I find that remarkable because the start to my day is uncannily similar. Have a Greg's pasty, then sit around watching the darts on Sky Sports. But essentially, it's the same. And I love this, the adverts page. Now, see if you could spot the odd one out of the adverts, all on one page. Gothic belly dancing workshop. Sound healing. Use the power of sound to heal yourself. The Merlin energy experience. And lastly, man with a van for all removals. Presumably he goes around people's houses going, all right, goddess, where do you want these Ouija boards? 4 sugars in me ginseng, love. All right. But there must be a reason why Glastonbury attracts this sort of attention. It can't just be that hundreds of crystal healers and goddesses went to the Glastonbury Festival one year and were so out of it they missed it by 7 miles and think it hasn't started yet. First of all, I should ask, I mean, how many people here were brought up in Glastonbury? Yeah. There's a few, but mostly not, right? But, although the area has always attracted spiritual types through the tour and its Christian and Arthurian connections, but the modern wave of new immigration, as far as I can work out, it seems to have started in the 70s. Now, there was some resistance to this, I think it's fair to say. So I'd like to introduce you to Tom Gillam. How long have you lived in Glastonbury or around this area?
50 years.
So you've lived here in both sort of times, if you like,
BC.
Okay, what do you call it?
Before crystals.
Before. Right. Right. What was the time like when there was a transition then? Can you remember any sort of hostility to people that were coming in?
No.
Growler. You can't. So. Because a lot of people have told me that lots of the cafes, in fact, all the cafes except one, apparently, had a sign on saying no hippies. I mean, so does that count as hostility? I don't know.
Yes, I mean, caravans had glass smashed in. But, I mean, these guys were
that
living...
would count as hostility, wouldn't it?
I mean, it was probably small-town sport, you know. I mean, they didn't have anything better to do.
Now on Look West, we're going to look at the sports. Well, in Glastonbury, there were 17 windows put in, a hippies. Tom, also, what was the story you were telling me about the guy you remember at the petrol garage?
Well, I was in the lovely spring morning. The guy said, well, there's a few of them about this morning. And I said, well, it's the sunshine and the vibes. And he said, I lived here 60 years or more, and I'd bug it if I ever felt one.
A round of applause, though, for Tom. Thanks very much for coming along. Obviously, there are a few differences in outlook between the pre-New Age residents and the later ones. The book, The New Age of Glastonbury, interviewed people in the town, and it says, John, writer and physical immortalist, says Glastonbury is the heart's chakra, whereas Jane, a mother I interviewed who's not New Age, disagreed, saying, the place is full of weirdos. One reason for the mystical aura, if I can use that phrase, may be the Tor, the conical hill. All sorts of religions have gone up there to worship, built churches up there over thousands of years. There are quite a few.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.